What's up, guys? Welcome to Pass the AUX. If you're new here, the way the show works is we listen to various Christian artists, we react to their music, and we give our two cents in.
And also, we'll be having various guests on some of our episodes, and you guys should tune in. So, other than that, enjoy the episode.
What's up, guys, and welcome to a freestyle rap. You're supposed to say words. Welcome to Pass the AUX. Well, anyways, guys, we have two special guests here with us. We have Kira and Noah. We're super excited to have them. If you guys want to, you know.
Kyra?
It is Kyra. I'm sorry about that. she told us, like, right before, oh, yeah, I actually prefer Kyra. I was like, My bad, Kyra. But we do have Kyra and Noah here. Welcome, guys, to the show.
Welcome.
Super glad to have you. If you would like to share, you know, a cool little interesting fact about you guys real quick, we'd love to hear it.
An interesting fact. I think, for me, I love F1. It's my secret.
Formula, yep, one racing. Formula one.
It's like,
wow, okay.
You know,
that's pretty cool.
I have a little Formula One car on my keychain. Just a reminder.
Who's your favorite driver?
Charles Leclerc. But the thing is, here's the thing.
Charles what?
Leclerc. Charles Leclerc. But the thing is, this past season, I'm sorry to say, he really sucked. So I've switched
over.
Who
heard it here?
I switched over to Mercedes with Lewis Hamilton and George Russell.
Bandwagon. Wow.
Yeah, understandable.
Have you ever watched the movie Turbo? Anyways, Noah, what's your interesting fact?
My interesting fact is my favorite sea creature is jellyfish. That's
ooh,
it.
Ooh, jellyfish.
Jellyfish are sick.
Do you have, like, that's a specific sick jellyfish?
Yeah, dude, moon jellyfish. Ooh. They're the coolest looking ones.
What are the...
What's so cool
describe
about
them?
Him.
Describe yeah. them. Like, what does it look like?
Like a jellyfish?
No, but, like, what does... Like, you said it's the coolest looking one. There's, like
they
crazy...
They go...
Wow. You know? I could just imagine it right now. Underwater.
Well, we brought you guys on here because we... for those of you who don't know, Noah and Kyra are both worship leaders. And I've been truly impacted by their worship, and so has David.
Yes.
So we really just kind of want to start off with a question, you know, like, what's really, like, your personal heart behind worship and, like, why you worship the Lord and everything like that, especially when you, like, lead and all of that stuff. If you whoever wants to go first.
You want me to go to first, Kyra?
Yeah.
Okay. Growing up, I always loved music. Grew up in a musical family, so it's kind of like what we did. Mm-hmm. And, also grew up in church, so we would like, play and worship. But I didn't really understand what worship was. I thought it was just, you know, singing to the Lord. That's, like, the basic understanding of mm-hmm. it. But as I grew deeper in my relationship with him, I realized, oh, man, this is, like, one way that I'm able to really bless his heart.
Yeah.
And, you know, I think we can take for granted so often, like, how kind he is, how faithful he is to us. And worship is just something that he deserves in the first place, right?
Yeah.
So, to me, worship is just me spending time with the one that I love and singing about how much I love him. Mm-hmm. So.
I'm like, dang, I should have gone first. Wait, but what was the question again?
Just really, like, what's your heart behind worship? And, like, especially when you lead, like, really, why do you worship and all of that stuff? Or, like, your individual heart?
Yeah, I think recently, like, realizing why I was worshiping and who I was worshiping really, like, changed my perspective on it. Because mm-hmm. I really, for all time, I was like, we're coming and we're singing, like, Jesus, woo! And then and then later I kind of realized, like, I'm really worshiping just to love on God and just really, like, dang, like, why wouldn't I? Like, mm-hmm. I've just, like, fallen in love and, mm-hmm. Yeah, just pretty much loving on God. That's basically, like, how I can sum it up all together.
Yeah.
That's awesome.
Yeah,
that's awesome. So good. How has music impacted your everyday life? Like, the music you guys listen to, how does it impact you every day, you know? And why is it important to kind of know what you're listening to?
guess I'll go first on this one.
Yeah, you can go first on this one, Kyra.
No, I'm trying to pass it off to you so you can go first.
But I know.
I think, I just really had one of those, like, have you ever had a moment? choosing what you listen to, I think it is important just because what you're filling yourself up with is, like, what eventually is going to, what's that, like, one verse out of the abundance of the heart? The mouth speaks, and so right. What you're filling yourself with, what you're listening to, it's going to come out eventually. Mm-hmm. So why not just fill yourself up with, like, music that's actually going to be, impactful, yeah. That's actually going to be, like, worth, like, it's actually going to do something for me.
Right. Yeah.
Like, why am I going to listen to why am I going to listen to something that's not really going to do much for me except, like, make me depressed and,
that's
like,
right.
give me anxiety. So.
Awesome.
Yeah, dude. I mean, I think a lot of people have different ways of how they enjoy themselves or deal with things. But I think the most common out of anything is music. People use music as a coping mechanism. They use it as something to, you know, get their spirits up or just to have fun, vibe out. Like, music is something that almost everybody, you know, has the privilege of listening to. And I know even from my own experience, like, music would, like, directly affect how I feel. Like, sometimes, like, when I was growing up, I really loved screamo and punk rock music, bro. Dude, for real. So I was like, and then I remember, dude, I was such an angry kid. Like, I was so angry all the time. And I was like, oh, I hate this. I wonder why, bro. It's because literally all the music that I'm listening to is like, man, like, let's stick it to the man, like, screw this, screw that. Like, that's literally what it was. Yeah. And then, like, even later on in my life, like, you know, there are times where you're like, man, I need to calm down, or I need peace. You put on, like, water and bird sounds, you know? And that's, like, super soothing. You're like, oh. So there's something about, like, the things that we put in our ears and that we allow to, like, I guess, manipulate and affect our moods that music has, like, that's the kind of effect that it has on us. So
I totally agree with that, and I think this is why both of us are doing this podcast, because I mean, we both love music, you know, and I think music is just such a big influence in everyone, really.
For real.
It's just really what really just connects us, you know, because I don't know, like you said, it just puts you in a mood, you know, like, mm-hmm. either being mad or angry or needing to get some peace, you know. So, that's what we're going to do today.
Yeah. So this week, we're actually going to not, usually on previous episodes, we listen to Christian artists who have, like, songs that we want to review and, like, really, like, listen to and, like, break down the lyrics. But actually, this week, we're going to switch it up, and we're going to listen to a secular artist who actually had a song that kind of was like a weird curveball, and it was kind of like, oh shoot, that's like talking about the Lord, like that kind of like, and we want to preface that me and David have both heard it before, but you guys haven't, so we really just want to, like, play it for you guys, and then I sent you guys the lyrics, so you can look it on your phone, just so we can go over. So guys, this week we are going to be playing the song "Holy Spirit" by Stormzy. Shout out Stormzy.
Yes. All right, let's get into it.
Let's start playing it.
Music does he use? Do
usually, like, you know, like, well, he's British. I'm like 90% sure he's British, but, like, you know,
hold up.
He's like making British rap, I think, or like rap in general, kind of.
Okay.
But so then also like an R&B type of thing.
Okay. So this is like more like a ballad or something.
Yeah, it's more like a ballad.
Okay.
A slower song on his album.
Got it.
If you knew the pressure, the pressure on my shoulders.
He's got a smooth voice.
Buttery
answers.
Father, help me hold this. A cause I can't bear the pressure. If you need a burden,
this is super gospel-y.
The burdens are so heavy. Lord, you made me ready to carry all my burdens.
Yeah, bro, you're like stealing the spotlight.
If you need a power, the power that's inside me, what's mine cannot pass by me. Mighty God Almighty. Hold me close, fill me with your presence, Holy Ghost and Spirit. Father God, I found it. Lord, keep me surrounded.
You can pause it. It's like, this is a curveball, right?
Right.
You're telling me he's a secular artist, but he's like singing about this subject matter. It's kind of like, oh, dang.
Right.
Maybe this guy's like just found who the Lord is, right?
Yeah.
And he's like singing about it. Is that what it seems like?
Yeah.
That's what it seems like to me.
Like, yeah. I feel like if we didn't tell you who this guy was before and we just played the song, you just think it was like, you know, one of those contemporary Christian artists that like, you know, made like a slower ballad song.
Yeah.
And he was just singing about it.
All right, let's keep on going.
Yep.
Isn't it amazing that faith was all we needed to find the missing pieces? Oh, I've been searching for my Jesus. Times when I felt worthless, you gave me peace and purpose.
That's fire.
I love it.
Although I don't deserve it, although I'm far from perfect, I need you to hold me close, fill me with your presence, Holy Ghost.
Kyra, are you debating on doing this on
Father
Sunday?
God, I found it.
Can you hear this on Sunday? Like the background, like when
Lord, Pastor Andrew's like, me okay, so let me shoot
the background.
Holy Spirit, I don't know what this is. It's a dread, it's a feeling you give. Oh Lord, came in and you filled me with bliss. It's a feeling I don't want to resist. Oh Lord, Holy Spirit, show me the way. Hold me with your tight embrace. Oh Lord, you will never lead me astray. Now I am no longer afraid. You're the reason why I pray. Fill me with the light of day. When you hold me in your arms, makes me feel some type of way. Oh, you'll be there when I'm cold. Lord of all, oh, 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 oh. If you need my story, Lord, what do you have for me?
What do you have for me?
You made me feel so hopeful.
Hopeful.
I'm just glad I know you.
Who's this?
I love her voice.
No, it doesn't say.
I'm so glad I know you.
Well, y'all better find out.
She is popping off.
Hey, that was good.
That was so good.
So yeah, that was Holy Spirit by Stormzy. What do you guys think?
Kyra, initial thoughts?
Initial thoughts.
I thought it was really good. Like, in like listening to the song, I was just like, the wordplay that he used, like the wording that he used in the song was like just so.
Yeah.
It was so specific. It was so, it seemed genuine.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it seemed, like you said, genuine to me. Like, it sounds like, I don't want to make a, like, shot in the dark judgment on who Stormzy is, because I don't know him. Mm-hmm. And I don't know any, I haven't done any research, but sounds like he's like being earnest, like he's found the Lord and is talking to the Lord. So I think that's pretty good.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's awesome. Yeah. I think for me, the part where he says, isn't it amazing that faith is all I needed or something like that? That part just hit me, because I remember when I got saved, I was in the car and I was like, wait, that's it? That's all I needed? Like,
yeah.
Like, you know, like religion makes it seem like it's so, you got to do all these things, you know, so you can get close to God. But really, it's just faith.
Mm-hmm. That's good. Yeah.
And I was like, oh. And like when I heard that, like it took me back to like when I first found Jesus and I first found him. And and it, I don't know, it's just really amazing and super cool.
Yeah. On the music side, just talking about the music, it's nothing like super groundbreaking.
Yeah.
Like I hate to be the the rain, the storm cloud and the 100%. You know, everybody's like, but I'm just like, music not like 100% groundbreaking. Like if you listen to any old gospel record, you'll hear the same exact thing, same sounds, same arrangement of how they do the choirs and stuff.
Right.
But I think that's kind of what he was going for, right? And he executed it well, because he's going for that ballad / gospel choir vibe, which he nailed. So
yeah.
He really brought it back.
Mm-hmm. He did.
brought it back where? You were like born in 2005.
He brought it back so I can hear it. I've heard it in my parents' CDs.
Oh, okay. My bad. I'm sorry, Kyra. That's my
My mom had a 2016 car with a CD player. Boop.
One lyric that I want to point out is in the third verse. It says, Holy Spirit, I don't know what this is. So drained. It's the feeling you give, oh Lord. Came in. You fill me with the bliss. It's a feeling I don't want to resist, oh Lord. Mm-hmm. Sometimes, like at first, like I'm sure you guys can relate to this. Like when you encounter Jesus, oh, the feeling is like undeniable. Mm-hmm. You're like, oh, this feels so good to like actually give up everything and to actually know the Lord. But as you guys probably know, feelings fade quickly.
They do. 100%.
Right? When circumstances happen, when things don't go your way and you're like, oh man, what the heck? Feelings go quick.
Yeah.
So my only word is like, hey man, like if your relationship or if anyone's relationship based on God is based on the feeling that he gives you,
right?
Oh man, you gotta go a little bit deeper than that in order to maintain something.
No, 100%.
Because feelings will only get you so far. It's intimacy and it's relationship. Mm-hmm. It's covenant that will actually stand those trials. It'll stand the test of time. So that's the only thing I saw here that I was like, oh, maybe he's in the infancy stage of his walk with the Lord.
For those of you who are watching, Stormzy's also a secular artist, so make sure that you are only listening to good things. So if you're gonna listen to any song by Stormzy, make it this one and only this one. Right, David?
Yep, that is totally right. Just be mindful of what you're listening to, because remember, your ears are the Holy Spirit's ears. You know, all your whole body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. So just be mindful of what you're doing with it, you know? So.
For real. All right. It is what we usually do to rank the song, or not rank, rate the
song.
Oh,
yes.
At the end of every episode. So let's start off with
what's
Noah,
the scale?
So the scale is, do we usually
1 to 10.
Yeah, 1 to 10. It's usually like 1 to 10.
1 to 10? Man, we were kind of like praising the song. Would I be mad if it came on like the radio or something? No, wouldn't be mad. Mm-hmm. Would I like actively want to listen to it? Probably not.
Right.
Not that I didn't like it. I appreciated it. I liked it. Mm-hmm. I think I'll give it a solid 6.
Solid 6,
yeah.
Word. Kyra?
I'm giving it a 7 because I love that the runs that she did at the end.
Oh, bro, I forgot about that.
Those runs are like what?
She kind of killed it at the end.
Oh,
yeah. I'm going to be a man of my word.
So you're at like a 6 for like the most of it, and then like the runs just like.
The runs just elevated it to like 7. Yeah.
That's good.
You got to find who that girl is.
No, for real.
For real.
That was fire.
We'll find out.
I'll call him. It's all right.
I'll call him. All right, David?
For me, I'm going to give it a good 6.5.
6.5?
You know, yeah.
Yeah.
I really liked it. You could tell, you know, he put, you know, his whole heart into it, you know, and like this is his testimony, you know? So yeah. I think it's really cool.
Dang, now that you say that, I just gave his testimony a 6. Bro, that's so...
It's just like, you know, would I play it like constantly? No, I'd play it like here and there, you know. Yeah. And so yeah, that's it.
I'ma say also a 7, same with Kyra. Is it a song that I'd be I wouldn't be mad if it came on. It's not like a song that I'd be like, yeah, you know what, like, if I'm going to spend time with the Lord, like, this is what I put it, like, definitely not.
Yeah.
This is kind of like, if I just want to, like, idly do work and just be, like, you know, listening to good music, this would be, like, in a playlist that I put in. It wouldn't be, like, oh, I'm going to play this song specifically. Like, you know, when you have, like, a playlist, and you go, I'm going to start off with that song because that's the song I'm going to listen to right now. Like, now right. It's, like, you know, 30 minutes into your playlist and you hear, it's like, yeah. So I think it's a solid 7. It's still a good song. So other than that, thank you guys for... Thank you guys for tuning into this week of Pass the Aux. But make sure you turn in to the next episode because we have 2 special guests. It is going to be our homies, our really good friends. It is Lauren. For those of you who don't know Lauren. We're going to put her picture right here. Lauren, hopefully you get one shoot where she's like, you know, a little crazy. And then we're also going to have our homie DJ. For those of you that don't know DJ, he's that 6'4 man, tall man, beautiful man.
Yeah.
Man very beautiful.
Curly
very
hair.
Beautiful man. Can confirm.
Very curly man hair.
Other than that,
DJ.
We hope you guys like this episode. We hope to see you next week. Later, tune guys. In the next episode. Peace.
Peace.
Bye.
Hey, guys. Hope you enjoyed this episode of Pass the Aux. If you did, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe down below. We had a blast filming this episode, and we can't wait for you guys to tune in on the next one. Catch you on the next one. Peace.